everybody. So today I was reading through all of your guys's lovely comments, and many of you suggested that I watch the full Nothing is Eternal documentary instead of just the small portion that I watched, and so we're going to do that.
Hallo, mitt navn Aurora, og ingen musiker fra Norge. Jeg vet ikke om jeg kommer til å være her om en liten stund, fordi alt kan skje også. Og derfor skal jeg lage denne videoen for å passe på at alle tingene, alle de vakre tingene jeg synes er verdt å huske, skal bli husket. Growing up in Bergen has been like the most beautiful gift I can ever get, and learn that you can create this whole world for yourself because you have the space to do it, and that's so important. I've had a really special childhood with lots of magical happenings and imagination above all. Apples are so magical. I believe that everyone has a secret wish hidden in them. And you have to wish it after taking a bite. The wonderful thing about making music with yourself is kind of a way to stop time. Just in the moment, as I sit down, and then you just play. I started writing melodies when I was 6 years old, and then the words came when I was 9. And after I discovered one of my greatest weapons in life, words, I never stopped. Music is not something you should keep for yourself. It can't be put in a cage because it's wild and alive. I have 2 sisters, and they're both amazing creatures.
Miranda.
That's me.
And hello. Victoria.
In the middle.
Makeup artist and designer, and me.
The first time I heard you sing was when you got that present from your friend. It was like a session in a studio, yeah. And you recorded one song. And I don't think she knew how well she did.
No.
She was like, oh, is this nice? And yeah. I was like, what? It's beautiful. We were always worried about you. That you were going to be bullied or picked on because you were so weird, and you dressed so weird.
Yeah.
And we were so scared that going to be so tough on you to go to high school and these things. But you were like, no, it's
fine. But everybody loved you.
These are some of my very, very good friends, and I don't think I would have had so much fun in high school without them.
I remember when I first met you, I was like, oh my god, this girl is magic.
I think we got very different the first impression. Yeah.
Let love conquer your mind. Warrior. Eller to, da.
Er det den laveste?
Even though you have so many fans and people who say they love you and they've never met you, it's really important to also have friends who actually know you.
Yeah, I know you as you. Not the artist, but like we know you as you, and I know you as you.
Let love conquer your mind. Warrior, warrior, just reach out for the light. Warrior, warrior, I am warrior.
This is Yvonne. She's one of the only people that knew me from when I was 6 years old, and that also knows how it is being a bit more than just a normal teenager, I guess.
I don't really think you've changed in that sense. Of course, everyone changes, but I think the essence of you is still the same. It just feels like you've grown into yourself and just kind of figured out who you are.
Do you feel like you can relax when you come home, or do you feel like you're constantly working?
I have ants in my feet that wants me to go to the studio if I have a day off.
Yeah.
Because I guess I feel like I have an opportunity to make something new.
You do a take and it's pitch perfect and you say, oh no, that wasn't really good. And we have to like, yeah, that was good. And I'm like, no, I'll do it over again. And we're like, oh, come on.
You always tend to dance on the chairs. And now we have like 5 broken chairs in the studio, which is really annoying. You're always going to the studio though.
Unless you're in like London or Berlin or New York or
somewhere
LA.
Cool, yeah. Not raining.
I didn't travel much to big cities before I was signed by my management. So music has basically taken me everywhere. The first time I went to a big city was a strange feeling of being in an ocean, not really knowing how to breathe or move. It was very inspiring as well, because it was a very different world from the world I know.
You mean a furlis in Magis?
I used to come to this island very often when I was a child. It's quite strange how nothing can remind you more that things have changed than visiting a childhood place, because everything is the same. The trees and the smell and the silence, but one thing is different, and that's you and the way you see things and the way you think.
just like in fiction, in every addiction. Oh, fantasies taking over, awakening.
The more I travel around and live, and the more people I meet, you realize how nothing is eternal, not even me.
I thought I should make this video so my voice can keep talking after I'm gone, about things that I think is important to remember.
The lovely people I've met and
things I like
and places I find to be the most beautiful.
So those things will be remembered.
During that one. I feel like she has like the childhood I always like wish I could have had, like the magical beauty. I love the thing about the apples, and then she's like the and her friends and they float in the magic, and oh my goodness, this is so sweet. I'm really glad I checked out the whole video. It's definitely missed out on some really sweet and emotional moments. So thank you guys for tuning in and suggesting that I check out the rest of the documentary. I hope you guys all have a good day and you could experience a little of that of Aurora's magic too. Feel free to leave a comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!